Good day, this is Jim Pytel from Columbia Gorge Community College. This is Digital Electronics. This lecture is entitled Edge Detection. Before we go into our next sequential devices, namely the D flip-flop and the JK flip-flop, we need to have a brief discussion about edge detection. Before we do that, what I'm going to do is just talk about obstacles. Before I got my commission in the U.S. Army, I was actually an enlisted soldier for quite some time as a 12 Bravo combat engineer. And so what does the combat engineer do? It basically puts a bunch of things in the way of the bad guy to delay them. And one of the things that is a really effective obstacle is this thing called an abatis. Abatis have been around for a long time, and all it is you just fell a bunch of trees so they interlock and you point the sharp ends towards the bad guy. And what's really cool about an abatis is it's a little known fact. At night, the abatis, all those sharp branches that are pointing towards the bad guy, all migrate to eye level, groin level, and shin level. So if you could imagine going through an abatis, you'd go pretty slow. And the good guy would have a little bit more chance to shoot at you. Let's forget about the obstacles and go into actually what we're talking about now, edge detection. All right? So our SR latch, which we've discussed thus far, has this enable input on it. The enable input is kind of this large pulse where it's accepting inputs during that whole period. What we're going to try to do is just do a very, very, very simple modification to the enable input and allow us to have pinpoint accuracy as to when we are going to accept those inputs. And that we're going to do is just create a simple edge detection circuit. And as the name implies, edge detection, it's looking for an edge. Remember those four things I discussed about clocks, namely active high, active low, positive edge or rising edge or leading edge, and falling edge or trailing edge or negative edge. All right, so there are two edges we can potentially synchronize our clock on, and that's pinpoint accuracy. It's a very, very brief window of time where we're going to go ahead and accept inputs when we are using an edge detection device. And the circuit to actually develop edge detection is very simple. All we do is do this right here. And what I'm going to do is, you know how the SR latch works with an enable on it. All it is an AND gate with one input, and in this particular case I'm calling it clock, being the regular clock, and the other one being the complemented version of it, not clock. And if I wanted to go ahead and do this on, for example, a D latch, I could do the exact same thing. Here on the left, we've got a positive edge detection SR latch, and on the right, we've got a positive edge detection D latch. All right, some of you may be freaking out because you remember from combinational logic a certain Boolean property. Okay, that certain Boolean property, which we seem to be violating, is this: A and not A is always equal to zero. I thought we were active high enable right here. Okay, so we're still looking for a high on that enable. We're still looking for a high on that enable. How could that circuit, A and not A, ever produce a high if you've previously told me this is true? A and not A. An example is if clock is zero, not clock is one. Clock ends not clock is zero. If clock is one, not clock is zero. Clock and not clock is also zero. So you seem to be violating those enable conditions. We want a high input for that enable, for that active high SR latch and that active high D latch to work. How does this work? Well, check it out. We have been dealing with idealized versions. In reality, there exists this thing called propagation delay. It takes some time for that signal to get through the NOT gate. When I put that NOT gate there, what I really mean is this. The biggest NOT gate you could possibly get. Inside that NOT gate is a bunch of abatis with sharp branches pointing towards that clock signal, and it's delaying it. I'm basically taking a long time to get through that NOT gate, and because of the delay, because of those obstacles, this is not a typical NAND gate. It's a big old NAND gate with a bunch of sharp abatis pointing the clock signal in the eye, in the groin, and the shins as it tries to get through that NAND gate. I've basically taken off the shoes of the clock signal and spilled a bunch of Legos on the floor, and I'm making them walk across that floor barefoot. The point is, I've delayed that clock signal coming through the NOT gate. What you get is this really neat property. Clock and not clock signal does not always equal zero. Africa because of the propagation delay. So let's use this example right here where I've got the clock signal and the not clock signal where there is a delay. Basically, when clock changes, not clock has a tiny little bit of a delay. And that AND gate will see two simultaneous ones on it and your enable will go briefly high. So go ahead, let's put some input on the clock input and we'll see what the not clock looks like with a delay. Okay, so there is our clock input. We've got a 1 going down to a 0, going back up to a 1. And again, we're looking for a positive edge detection, which is the edge where I want to find, where I want that enable to work. Probably right there. So let's see if some magic happens here. What does the not clock look like? Well, it looks exactly like the clock, except it's inverted. However, there's a delay. And let's pretend this right there is the amount of delay that occurs. Let's say it's 5 nanoseconds or 25 nanoseconds or whatever, some arbitrary measurable period of time. Okay, so what is not clock? Well, clock is 1, so not clock is 0. And in a perfect world, it would instantly switch right here. However, there is a delay. Because that delay, what do we have here? Our enable is ANDing them. 1 ANDed with a 0. Well, we should probably have a 0. What do we have now? 0 ANDed with a 0. It's still a 0 for our enable. So we have not falsely detected an edge because it's a negative edge in this particular case. We're not worried about the negative edge. We want a positive edge. Let's go along. Clock is staying at 1. Not clock is staying, excuse me, clock is staying at 0, not clock is staying at 1. And in a perfect world, right here, it would switch. But because there's all those Legos all over the floor and the clock signal's barefoot and there's a bunch of branches poking him in the eye and the groin and the shins, it's slightly delayed. It stays a 1 until it shifts right here. So check this out. You've got this brief moment in time right there where clock and not clock are simultaneously a 1. What happens to our enable signal? There's a brief high pulse, which, if we remember all this right here, that's all that enable's looking for. It's a high. That's all that enable is looking for right there. So what you get is this edge detection device. It is enabled only at a rising edge. And this simple modification, the edge detection device added to the front of some of our previously discussed devices, can give us that pinpoint accuracy we want. Only find those input signals on those positive rising or leading edges. If you wanted to create a negative edge detection device, all you would do is just invert that. So let's go ahead and apply some of these edge detection devices to a device we've previously used and come up with a functionality for that device.